Scam artists hammer college campuses all the time, and many students might not realize when they come across a scam. In tonight's Consumer File, Debbie Dujanovic has three schemes students and their parents should know.
Scams are very real and they're all over the place, so.
University of Utah student Sydney Townsend learned firsthand when she got this call.
We are calling from the registrar's office. We see that you have some unpaid dues. If you don't pay these dues, you'll get dropped from your classes.
It's called the tuition scam. Bad guys pose as school officials and demand to be paid by credit card or gift cards immediately.
And I just told them I wasn't comfortable doing that, and I would go speak to the registrar's office and pay him there.
Sydney did the right thing. Unfortunately, many students don't know how to handle scammers, says Weber State consumer protection expert Randy Boyle.
Students are particularly vulnerable because they're not necessarily wise to the ways of the world.
Well, here's another big scam Boyle wants to warn students about. Fake jobs.
Students are hungry for money. They always use a little extra cash for various reasons.
Scammers post fake jobs promising students a big check. But here's the catch. They're required to wire part of that check to the boss's preferred vendor for supplies. Oh, the check is bogus, and students are out the money they wired.
Never, ever pay an advance payment for anything.
You freshman Taylor York just found a job the right way.
It's a campus job, so online, like through my website, my campus website.
Now, college campuses have job centers that will help students find legitimate work. Next, we want you to look out for the textbook scam.
It was like a pack of three, and it was like $200.
So I spent over, I think, up to $500.
Scammers set up websites selling textbooks for $5 to $20. Well, they take the money all right, but they don't ship you any books.
My dad has always told me if it's too good to be true, then most likely it's a scam.
So buy textbooks from reputable sites. Try Amazon, Chegg, or textbooks.com, or from the bookstore. Yeah, you'll pay more than $5, but at least you'll have the book you need to pass the class. Back to you.
All right, good point, Deb.